Today we're going to talk about how to install a servo on the Bigtree Tech SKR Pro version 1.1. This is a servo that does 180 degrees. I'll leave a link in the description where you can find it on Amazon. And just to let you know, I purchased the materials for this video with my own money. So first of all, with the servo, I need to explain that we have a brown wire here, that's our ground. Then our red wire here is our voltage, or 5 volts usually. And then we have our orange wire, which in this case is signal. Now, I have jumper wires to show you how to connect it, because on here we're gonna use, in this case, the ports that we use for the BL touch, and I'll also show you how to change where you can use these ports. But let me point them out for you. First of all, we have our one on the very end of the BL touch over here, which is our 5-volt pin. The next one over right here is our PA1. That would be our sensor pin. And then the next one over is ground. Those are the three of the four pins that we're concerned with. So to connect this, what we're going to do is we're going to use jumper wires. So I'm going to connect the ground right here. Next, I'm going to connect the sense pin, which is right here. And then finally, I'm going to connect the voltage pin, which is right here. Then what we're going to do is we're going to pick this up, and we're going to connect those colors to the colors that we currently have. So I'll start with the orange one, which is our sensor. And that goes in there, as you can see. Next, I'll do the ground pin, which is on the far edge, would be our brown wire in this case. And then finally, I'm going to do the voltage pin, which is in the center. So those are the three pins that we need to worry about. Now, in order to program it, what we're going to need to do is we're going to need to take our SD adapter and pop out our TF card and put it in the adapter. And then we're going to place this inside the computer, and you'll hear a beep. Okay, to start with, I want to show you the SD card. Currently, we have firmware in all capital letters, and it's a cursor type file. So we're going to go over to Atom with PlatformIO loaded, and I'm going to show you real quick what it looks like here. So this is our folder, kind of unfolded, but it's for Marlin-bugfix-2.0.x. In order to set this up, what you're going to need to do is download Marlin firmware from the website for this version. You're then going to need to unzip it. After you've unzipped it, you're going to go to File, and you're going to open the folder for Marlin-bugfix-2.0.x. So the first thing we need to do to set this up is open up the Marlin folder, then the source folder, then go to Core, and then open boards.h. Inside boards.h, we're going to do a search on SKR Pro, and this is the board definition we're looking for, which is board_bigtree_skr_pro_v1_1. We're going to copy this, then we're going to close out of this folder, and then we're going to close boards.h, and we're going to go to configuration.h. inside configuration.h, we're going to search on motherboard. And we're going to highlight board_ramps_14_EFB and we're going to paste what we just copied. Then we're going to scroll up and we're going to change our serial port to -1 because we're using the TF drive with the SD card. So we're going to search now on num_servo. And as you can see right now, the servo is commented out. So we're going to remove the comment. So now it's enabled. We're then going to change number of servos to 3, or excuse me, from 3 to 1, because we only have one servo connected. And this is a delay time that you can play with on your own time, but this is about a third of a second. So next we're going to go over to PlatformIO.ini, and currently our default environment is set for the Mega AT Mega 2560. We're not using that chipset, so we need to find ours. So we're going to search on SKR_Pro, and here it is. So we're going to highlight this being BigTree_SKR_Pro and copy it. Then we're going to page back up and we're going to highlight Mega AT Mega 2560 and paste over it. So that's how we set up our environment. Now, to show you where our pins are, first of all, if you go to the manual that I'll show a link to in the description, you can see how I described the 5-volt pin for the BL Touch. Then we have PA1, and then we have ground. PA1 is our sense pin. So in order to work with that or find it, we're going to go over here if you were to choose to relocate it and click on source. Then you'd click on pins, and then you'd scroll down to STM32. And inside here is our board definition for pins. So we're going to open this up and we're going to search on servo. And as you can see, servo 0 pin is PA1. So that's where it comes from and how we know it's there. So we're going to close out of this for pins. And I'm going to click the checkbox to compile our firmware changes. And then I'll click save. Okay, now that it's finished compiling, we can check to see if it's successful by clicking on PlatformIO, then clicking toggle build panel. And as you can see, it says that it was successful. So we're going to close that down by saying toggle build panel. Now, in order to find our actual build so we can load it onto the TF drive for the SD card, we're going to click on the build folder, then the SKR Pro. We're going to right click, and then we're going to go to show in Explorer. Now, as you can see, it's down here, so I'm going to click on that. Now, I'm going to open up this folder. Inside this folder, we have our build. So I'm going to right click on it and I'm going to say send to, and I'm going to send it to our SD card. Now it's in our SD card. I'm going to verify it's there. So we do have our firmware.bin. Okay, now that we have our build on the TF drive, I'm going to pull out the TF drive from the SD adapter and I'm going to place it in the slot for the TF drive. Now I'm going to take the serial USB, the big side, and connect it to the BigTree Tech SKR Pro. Then I'm going to take the small side of the SD cable for the serial USB and connect it to the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. You're also going to see a flash right around here for the firmware loading. Okay, now that the firmware is loaded, we're going to go over to Pronterface to test it. Okay, we're in the Pronterface folder, so I'm going to connect to Pronterface. I'm then going to connect to the SKR Pro version 1.1. Now that it's online, in order to move the servo, what we need to type is M208 space P0 space S, and we'll do 120 to see what happens. And here we go. Now that we've seen it move, let's see if we can move it back. So we'll do S minus 120 and see what happens. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.